I also just want to address the issue of schoolies. Now, of course, we know we are in a different time at the moment, and of course the world's going through a global pandemic and things aren't as they would normally be. And can I first of all commend, you know, all of our teachers out there, the students, and the fact that we actually have people attending our schools in Queensland. There has not been those huge disruptions to classroom education that we have seen in Victoria and we have seen in other parts of the world. And of course, I think there are even comments being made about in Europe at the moment, there are concerns about schools going back with large outbreaks of coronavirus in countries such as France overnight. So what I want to say to everyone is I want to thank everyone for the way in which our schools have been open and the way that the whole education system has responded. So we've had to look at this issue very seriously and from a cross-agency perspective, but fundamentally, as Queenslanders know, we always listen to the health advice. And the Chief Health Officer has deemed the event of schoolies, it is a mass event over multiple days, is high risk. So the schoolies that we have come to know over the years will not be able to go ahead in that form this year. This is a very tough decision, but it is also a decision that Dr. Young will talk about, has been also discussed at AHPPC about mass events that are held across the country. So not just Queensland, across the country. And this is a mass event. It poses high risk to not only the people that attend, all of the young people, but also the people they come in contact with, and of course their families and their friends and their grandparents. So we've had to take that very tough decision. So there will be, unfortunately, no concerts, no organised events, because there can be no mass gatherings. Look, I've had a couple of detailed conversations with the Mayor of the Gold Coast, Tom Tate. He fully supports the advice from the Chief Health Officer, and I thank him for that. And I hope parents can understand and students can understand that this event cannot go ahead in this format this year. So we will be the Chief Health Officer and the Director General of Education will be writing out to all of the schools to inform the schools, and the Chief Health Officer and the Director General of Tourism will be writing out to all accommodation providers. However, we also know that our tourism sector does need support. So just as any other person can go along and book accommodation, people are welcome to continue to do that in those small groups right across Queensland. And families will be looking at booking their accommodation, and there is nothing wrong with small groups of people finishing school booking somewhere close to where they live as well, because as long as they actually abide by those rules and regulations that are set in place for hotel accommodation, then there is nothing to worry about. But it's a tough year for everyone, and hopefully things will get better by the end of next year and we can have a double celebration. But we are in a world pandemic, and I just hope everyone understands that. I know that Minister Di Farmer and Minister Grace Grace will also be talking to young people about other ways in which they can commemorate the fact that they have actually finished Year 12, and they'll be talking to young people about some other options and ideas around that. It has been a tough year for everybody, and I thank all of the Year 12s for the work that, well, the struggle really that they've had to go through this year with school being closed and then open. But we've had to make these decisions because it is about the health of everyone. So I hope everyone accepts that difficult decision, but it is the right decision and it is absolutely based on the best health advice that we can give you at this time.